Hello and welcome to SAP on Microsoft Azure. My name is Holger Bocholt, and in this video I want to talk about updating SAP data from Excel leveraging Power Automate. So again, we'll cover the Microsoft Power Platform in this video. We'll talk about Power Automate and specifically, but the Power Platform itself with its low-code, no-code platform really spans across multiple products containing Power BI, Power Apps, and Power Virtual Agents. Before we dive into this specific demo, let's quickly look back. So we started by integrating all data from an SAP system into Excel, actually without writing any single line of code. Then, after having this read-only scenario, we looked into updating SAP data directly from Excel. And we looked at developing web add-ins for Excel using Visual Studio and Visual Studio Code. But we also looked at using ScriptLab, which allowed us to really create within Excel TypeScript or JavaScript applications that could reach out to the SAP system and update data in the SAP system. Then we looked at creating a Power App that just accessed the SAP data that now was available in Excel, and we could create a beautiful application, again, without writing one single line of code, that would run as an application on your Windows laptop, that would run on a mobile application, that would run in a browser. And then we also looked at how we can actually update SAP data from Power Apps in the SAP system using OData and leveraging the custom connector of Power Automate. Now in this video, what we want to do, we want to leverage the very same custom connector and more or less most of the stuff that we have developed in the Power Automate script that we used in Power Apps, but this time we want to use it out of Excel. So the scenario would look like this. I have my Excel sheet with SAP data. So this SAP data is coming via OData from my SAP system. But then from Excel, we'll trigger a Power Automate flow that calls the custom connector and then updates data in the SAP system. So let's take a look. So starting point for our integration is again the SAP Developer System ES5. So here we can see the Fiori tile, we can see the list of products. So if I click on Go here, then we retrieve the list of products from the SAP system and everything is fine. Now, as we have shown before, I can also open up Excel. And if I just click here on Refresh, then we're connecting via OData to our SAP system and we're retrieving the latest information from our SAP system. Now, what we want to do is, instead of only having this read-only scenario, we now want to update data in the SAP system. For this, I've saved the document on OneDrive. And actually, if I open up here my OneDrive folder, I can see this SAP product data XSL sheet. Now, what I want to do is I want to create a new Power Automate flow. So I'll head over to Power Automate and I can actually start by creating a completely new flow. So what I want to do is I want to look for Excel integration scenarios. And as you can see, there's one very simple flow, a template that allows me to react for a selected row, complete a custom action. And that's what I want to do. So if I select this template, I could really create a completely new flow. I would connect to my Excel sheet on OneDrive. And that's basically it. So I would just here now configure the location. I would select that the data is coming from OneDrive. I would select this OneDrive as the library. Then I would select the file that I'm interested in. So this is here the SAP product data. And then I'll select the table that is available in this Excel sheet. So in this case, it's SAP products. Let me actually quickly go back to the Excel sheet. And if I click here on the table design, you can see that I've assigned a table name to the specific table. And that's exactly what we can see here in Power Automate. With this, I'm ready to go basically. So I now could create the next step and so on. What I've already done is I've prepared these steps already. So basically leveraging the flow, the Power Automate flow that we previously used for Power Automate, where we retrieve the product ID, obviously in this case from the Power Apps, and then we update the information in the SAP system. I've done the very same thing. So I've created a flow called update this role to SAP. And if I just take a closer look at this specific flow, you can see this is the starting point where I have the OneDrive document, where I have the file name, okay, that's the technical ID, but where I also have the SAP product. And then what I'm doing here in the next steps, okay, I'll just send an email notification just for me as a developer to check that everything is fine. But in the end, what I'm doing, I'm doing the very same thing. I do this get product. Now I'm obviously retrieving the product ID from my Excel sheet. I'll fetch the CSRF token and then I update the information in my SAP system. And in this specific case, I'm again taking the product ID, I put the CSRF token, the cookies, the e-tags, and then again I could update all the information here. I'm just updating the price in the SAP system. That's all that I'm doing. So let's head back over to Excel. And let's take a look at one of these notebooks. So I'll take the notebook 15. Currently, the price of this notebook is 808 euros. So let's just double check. I'll go to the Fiori screen. I search for HT1000 and I click on the search button, and then we'll see the price here in a second. Here you go, 808 euros. So US dollar. So what I want to do is I'll change this price to 900, and now I want to update this price in the SAP system. For this, what I can do, if I switch on to data, I can see there's a flow tab up here. If you don't have this, then just go to insert, get add-ins, and search here in the store for Power Automate or flow, and then here we go. Then we have the Microsoft Flow for Excel. Then just add this to your Excel sheet, and then you should also have this flow icon up here. Now, if I click this icon, then on the right-hand side, we're connecting to all the flows that my user, Adele Vence, is assigned to. So I need to sign in here. I select my user. I authenticate. And that's it. Now I have here the flows that are available in my specific system. Theoretically, I could also create a new flow, but I can see there's one flow existing, update this row to SAP. And if I just click on play or run, then it's connecting, checking if all the connections to SAP system and so on are fine. And then I just click on run flow. And that's it. Now the data has been updated in the SAP system. Meaning, if I switch back to my Fiori screen and I just look up this product again, then you can see that the price was updated to 900 US dollars. I can actually also take a look at the flow. So if I go back here to my flow overview, then you can see in the run history that first of all, the flow was executed successfully. I can see a certain row was success was selected. I can see it was this HT1000. I can see the price that we submitted, and obviously here in the get product, we fetch the CSRF token, and when we update the product, we send just the price to 900 euros. So without writing one single line of code, without knowing what an OData service is, I was able to create a flow that allowed me to retrieve the data from an Excel sheet and update this relevant information in the SAP system. Obviously, this flow could be a little more complicated, a little more productive ready, like really checking and evaluating the e-tag, whether I am accidentally overwriting some data in the SAP system that was changed in the meantime by someone else. But still, I hope you see how easy and straightforward this integration of Excel, Power Automate, and the SAP system is. Okay, I again hope that this quick demo showed you how easy it actually is to update SAP data directly from Excel using Power Automate, using the custom connector. And if this was interesting for you, I can only encourage you to try it out yourself. So in order to get started, first take a look at the OData integration into Excel, then maybe take a look at how to use Power Automate in the context of the custom connector and Power Apps, and then get started using Power Automate. So create your very first Power Automate flow, connect it to Excel, and then you should be ready to go. With this, thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe. Stay healthy.